The method you use to migrate your data depends on your needs. With Synology NAS, you can migrate your data via Migration Assistant, Hyper Backup, or HDD Migration. In this video, we'll introduce these three migration methods and walk you through the process. You'll find the timestamp of each section in the video description. Let's start off by introducing each method. Migration Assistant allows you to seamlessly migrate the folders, system configurations, and packages from your original Synology NAS to a new one. This helps you maintain service availability on your original NAS throughout the migration. Hyper Backup allows you to create a backup task to back up your folders, system configurations, and packages on your original NAS and then restore them on the new one. HDD Migration is where you manually remove the drives from the source NAS and insert them into the destination NAS. Next, let's look at the pros and cons of each migration method so you can decide which one is right for you. Use Migration Assistant if you want to migrate your data to a brand new Synology NAS with new drives or want to continue using your previous NAS during the migration process. With this method, there are several advantages. You can continue services during and after migration, and there is minimal downtime. However, there are restrictions on which NAS models can be used, and this method requires the destination NAS to have a larger storage pool than the source NAS. Use Hyper Backup if you want to use a new file system on the destination NAS, or if the other methods aren't suitable for your situation. Since Hyper Backup is a backup solution, using it to migrate your data means that you'll also have a backup of your data on hand. On top of that, using backup data restoration for migration is more secure than using the original data, since the original data won't be affected. There are also no restrictions by model, and you can choose which data and configurations you want to migrate. Plus, this method allows you to use a different file system on the destination NAS if you need. The cons of using Hyper Backup to migrate your data are that migration takes a longer amount of time, and the storage space on your destination NAS must be twice the size of that of the source. Use HDD Migration if your source NAS is damaged and you want to replace it. The instructions for this method may vary product to product. With this method, there are several advantages. The process is simple, you'll experience less downtime, and you can migrate all of your data and system configurations on recommended model pairings. Refer to the article link in the video description for more information. The downsides of this method are that you cannot change the storage pool or volume settings, and there are restrictions on which drives and NAS models can be used. If HDD migration is not recommended for your source and destination NAS models, we recommend you use Hyper Backup to migrate your data. Although migration helps you keep your data and move it to a new device, we strongly recommend backing up before continuing. Refer to the migration article link in the video description for more details. Before you start, make sure that the source NAS is running DSM 6.0 or above, and the destination NAS is running DSM 6.2 or above. The DSM version on the destination NAS is the same as or newer than that of the source NAS. Refer to the link in the description for a list of compatible models. Sign into the destination NAS and go to the Package Center. Find and install Migration Assistant. Launch the package, and the Migration Wizard will automatically launch and guide you through the migration process. Review the information on the welcome page and click Next. Enter the IP address or server name, administrator account, and password of the source NAS. Then, click Next. The system will do an initial check. If Migration Assistant detects any issues with the source or destination NAS, you must resolve them before continuing. Confirm the settings and click Done. A dialog box will appear to confirm the actions to be taken. Click Continue. Enter the password of the account you're currently signed into. click Submit after entering the password to begin the migration process. At the end of the system phase, a dialog box will appear when it's time to restart the destination NAS. Click Restart Now. After rebooting, sign into the destination NAS using the administrator account of the source NAS. A dialog box will appear listing the services that need to be manually configured. Click the link in the video description for more details. Once the migration process is complete, all services should be available and working properly on the destination NAS. Refer to the article on the screen for instructions on what to do after migrating. Before you start, make sure that the DSM version on the destination NAS is the same as or newer than that of the source NAS. First, you need to back up your data to the destination NAS. Install and configure DSM on the destination Synology NAS. Make sure both NAS are connected to the same local network and have Hyper Backup installed. Make sure that Hyper Backup Vault is installed on the destination NAS. Sign into the destination NAS and go to Storage Manager, Storage. To make sure the storage capacity is at least twice that of the source NAS, sign into the source NAS and go to Hyper Backup. Select Remote NAS Device and click Next. Enter the server name or IP address, administrator account, and password of the destination NAS. Specify which shared folder to backup data to and a name for the directory. Select the folders you want to back up. Select the applications you want to back up. Click Next and follow the instructions. Wait for the backup task to finish backing up data to the destination NAS. Next, you need to restore the backed up data. Sign into the destination NAS and go to Hyper Backup. Click the Restore button and select Data. Select Restore from existing repositories. Select Local Folder and USB as the restoration source. Choose a shared folder as the backup destination for files from the source NAS. We will choose Restore System Configurations and tick All System Configurations. Click Next when you're done. Select the shared folders you want to restore and click Next. Select the applications you want to restore and click Next. Depending on the packages you want to restore, a confirmation message may appear. Click Yes to continue. A summary of the restoration task will appear. Click Done to continue. Wait for the data to be restored to your destination NAS and click OK to complete the restoration. Before you start, make sure that the most recent versions of DSM are installed on the source and the destination NAS. Also, the DSM version on the destination NAS should be the same as or newer than that of the source. On the source NAS, go to Control Panel, Update and Restore. Make sure that the source NAS is running the most recent version of DSM. Shut down both Synology devices. Take note of the order each drive was installed in, and then remove the drives from the source NAS. We recommend installing the drives on the destination NAS in the same order that they were installed on the source NAS. Turn on the destination NAS and wait for it to boot up. Open a web browser on your computer and go to find.synology.com. If your destination NAS can't connect to the internet, use Synology Assistant to search for your NAS instead. Find the destination NAS and double-click on it. The status of the destination NAS should be migratable. Click OK to continue. If you see a warning message like, "Note, all data on the hard drive will be deleted," close the browser and make sure that you've installed the drives in the exact same order as they were installed on the source NAS. If the drives are in the correct slots, but you still see this message, do not proceed, or all of your data will be erased. Choose the option to download and install the newest version of DSM. If your destination NAS cannot connect to the internet, you can download DSM from the Download Center and install it manually. Once the installation is complete, sign in to the destination NAS. Go to Control Panel, Update and Restore. Go to the Configuration Backup tab and click Restore. Click Restore from a configuration file on your computer. Click Browse and choose the backup file that you saved on your computer earlier. Click Next. Choose the All System Configurations option and confirm. A warning message will appear on the screen. Click to confirm and wait for the system settings to be restored. Upon completion, the data should have been successfully transferred to the target NAS. Make sure to prepare a temporary drive for updating DSM on the destination NAS. On the source NAS, go to Control Panel, Update and Restore. Make sure that the source NAS is running the most recent version of DSM. Install a temporary drive on the destination NAS. Turn on the destination NAS. Open a web browser on your computer and go to find.synology.com. If your destination NAS can't connect to the internet, use Synology Assistant to search for your NAS instead. Find the destination NAS and double-click on it. A welcome screen will appear. Click Install to continue. Choose the option to download and install the newest version of DSM. If your destination NAS cannot connect to the internet, you can download DSM from the Download Center and install it manually. Click Next to continue. Once the installation is complete, shut down both Synology devices and wait for them to power off completely. Remove the temporary drive from the destination NAS. Take note of the order each drive was installed in, and then remove the drives from the source NAS. We recommend installing the drives on the destination NAS in the same order that they were installed on the source NAS. Turn on the destination NAS and wait for it to boot up. Sign into DSM and your data should be successfully migrated to the destination NAS. Refer to the article on the screen for instructions on what to do after migrating. To get the most out of your Synology NAS, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel or click on another video to keep watching.